Exactly.
Ms. Tisdale, do you?
Yes.
Just so you know.
Yes, sir.
It's very, it's possible, depending on the crowd, that we will open and immediately go that way into the other room.
Thank you for preparing me. I appreciate that.
But it depends on the crowd.
Gotta get down there. You're gonna miss me.
I would assume I just got back from vacation today, so I'm not sure.
We need to have a motion to move.
We're gonna relocate the meeting. Let's have a motion to take it out. If we're gonna come back in after folks leave, let's do a motion out there to bring it back over here.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Do I hear a motion?
A motion to move the meeting to the main commission.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
How are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
Did you get his picture?
I was pinning. Yes, sir.
Where are you?
Okay, anyway. I do see your point, yeah. I do see it there, 1%, or 1, yeah. Okay, so that is definitely worth pursuing.
Satisfactory or if you had a dissatisfactory?
Either way.
Either way.
Equivalent coverage it offered savings to the county.
There should be a letter in your book that I hope there is, which half is done. Further advised, the agreement is not subject to further modification, which we do not believe that it is. Recommend that the agreement be tolerated for at least 1 year.
I make a motion we approve the agreement with Lloyd's of London for stop loss insurance coverage for the inmate medical plan.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion.
Thank you.
Yes, unanimous. Thank you, Pat. Item 16, change order with Garney Companies.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. The Antioch Water Treatment Facility. When we first brought this to you, we had multiple options on this enhancement system to improve.
Mr. Chairman, can we take a short break, please?
How short?
10 minutes, 5 minutes.
10-minute break without exception? Okay, so we should be back here then at 4:45.
Depends. I mean,
every day after August, We need to make a decision.
15, it's another $1,250.
Mr. Chairman, we have a motion on the table.
Mr. Chairman, we have a motion on the table. No.
I'll second that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, I just didn't need to be, you need to die.
No, you're right.
See, sorry. Did you second?
He seconded it.
We have a motion and a second. There's no further.
Is that the appropriate thing to do? Would you think that we need to make a decision?
I did.
We're notorious for postponing right here, but
we did need to make a decision. Yes, sir.
Is 2 weeks okay?
No.
I don't know. Well, we've been listening to discussion and we've been that's because of silly analogies that are being presented to confuse the issues. Tim, what would you prefer? Would you postpone
the decision? I don't believe you can make a
decision. No, would you prefer us to make a decision tonight, one way or the other, or postpone it?
I would prefer, and I believe the operators would prefer to make a decision one way or the other. Because I think
that's what we need to do. Then let's make a decision.
Let's vote on his motion.
We have a motion and a second.
I'm going to withdraw my second on that.
We have a motion.
Yep.
I believe that the motion died for lack of a second or withdrawn second. I would make a motion that we approve the recommendation of staff, although I'm not sure I can articulate it the way that they would like it articulated. Tim, can you?
From what I heard from AECOM, my recommendation would be to allow them to move forward with the purchase of the membrane cassettes for phases 3 and 4 using Xenon D500D technology.
That is my motion.
Second.
That's the motion.
Will there be an acquisitions contract that will come back to that at some point, Donald?
No, that's already written into our agreement.
Thank you.
I believe we have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion.
Wow. No staff recommendation?
I mean,
I don't think y'all understood that.
We have a wrong button.
I hit wrong button.
We have a wrong button. And
sorry.
We still need to clear the board and revote.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, I reached the wrong arm and died.
Okay, we have a motion to accept staff recommendation, which Tim just articulated, and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes 3-2. Thank you, everyone, for coming.
Just to note, I did not hear a time since the development of that, which means it will have to go on the next new business agenda on January 1st, I believe.
All right. We are on to item number 18, which I believe was not postponed.
Mr. Chairman, I can handle this very quickly. The board may recall this, and it's interesting. I did put one additional slide. This is out of the law, and it does say fourth line down, last third of that sentence. It is the express intent of the General Assembly in requiring renegotiation.
In terms of proposed schedule, we did include one in your books. Ideally, the planning staff and administration is suggesting that county and city.
One of them. About banner signs and prohibiting a banner type face from a permanent sign. The item on today's agenda is a series of 5 different options that have been discussed by the commissioners at past work sessions. And every time we voted to take a component of the work out to public hearing, it got the discussion rolling. It wasn't the only issue we were focused on, but it was one of the issues. And we've both adopted and have some pending work that would significantly change the way those signs operate and look. So as we have made some changes, we have other changes in the work that would significantly change the ability to print new signs. In regards to that, yeah, I would like to come back in the future. I would like to evaluate this and come back in the future if I see a problem. We have pending before you, we've conducted the first of two hearings on changes that would require a closure, where you wouldn't see the bungee cords and the straps on the inside of the sign. And we also have a change before you that would prohibit that stretch vinyl type face and would require a permanent face. The permits that are coming through my office, and if I see a new modified version of this type of sign that seems to have a lot of the characteristics that I heard concerns about at the end of last year and start of this year, I'll put in a new agenda request.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Tam being absent. I don't know exactly when he left.
My name is Claudia Castro. I'm the Managing Director of Smart Growth for Forsyth County. We welcome you. We ask you to please be polite, remain courteous. This is an opportunity for you to really have an intimate look at your candidates.
You get a chance for an open statement. You want to step up front, you can, if you're more comfortable. He is artistic direction here, so.
I know what happened last time. Somebody didn't do what she wanted. Thank you very much. I'm sorry I was not here. I just came back from an executive session and commissioner meeting right before that.
Please stand. Y'all see who are.
My name is Krista Morrissey. I'm living out of District 2.
Asking questions outside.
New business. Number one, Fowler Reclamation Facility Membranes, phases 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. As you are aware, we last discussed proceeding with phases 3 and 4 at the Fowler Wastewater Treatment Facility at the June 12th work session. At this time, we are again requesting authorization to proceed with phases 3 and 4 at the Fowler Wastewater Treatment Facility using non-500G membranes. This would correspond with our current contract with AECOM, who did design, build, and operate this plant. The actual cost is based on the $2,002 with the CPIU, which is the estimated cost of $946,470. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Chair will entertain a motion on this item. What's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we still accept the staff's recommendation for a Fowler Reclamation membrane for phase 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Second.
We have a motion and a second.
This is time sensitive, Council. We need to make it rush it.
Commissioner Warren, regular meeting. We don't need to do time sensitive.
Just a question. Could you call for discussion?
There's been a motion. We don't have a second.
Yeah, Todd's
do. Okay. You allow discussion in your motion? In your second? But go ahead, Ron.
All right, I have a question, Tim. I want to put you on the spot too bad, but you might have these numbers. And what was the original bid by these folks?
Which folks?
The
GE.
Yes, the GE.
We didn't receive bids, but AECOM got prices under their current contract for C, and the general, and they have a copy of that.
Sure. This process has been going on for about 9 days. What was the cost savings to the county?
I'm sorry.
Was there not a cost savings to the county?
What was that, 1.3 or 4 million? No savings to the county.
Okay.
It's all the operators' costs that are responsible for replacing phases 1 and 2 as needed and finishing the contract with phases 3 and 4.
Okay. So their bids that they kept, I mean, they did lower their bid.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, sir. Donald, do you remember, was it 1.3?
They did. I know that GE Xenon, when they're negotiating with AECOM, they came in and there had been a different scope of work that they'd been presented, and that was what they based their costing on. And then that scope of work was changed and they revised their pricing with AECOM. Those bids, like you said, were not directly with Forsyth County.
Okay.
Any more, Brian?
No reduction in installation costs or anything like that?
The current proposal, our understanding from AECOM, is that GE has dropped their price down considerably. I know there were negotiations a couple of times with them directly, and the price is much lower than it started out.
So are there any savings realized by the county?
No. It's all for the operator. The operator got the prices from GE, and they came to us. It was more than they expected to spend. In 2002, they failed to lock in a price. They guaranteed it to deliver it to us at a price, but they didn't have a contract locked in with GE, and so they asked to consider alternative membranes that could be affordable, and we told them if they could show the justification to us and benefit, we would consider it. And we allowed them to go out to other membrane providers. We provided some of them the cost that AECOM had anticipated spending, so they would know what ballpark area they can make it work. And okay. There's been a lot of discussions with AECOM and vendors.
All right.
Dan, just a couple of questions before we vote on this. We have a copy of a letter from Woodard and Curran that
yes.
suggests that they recommend the Kubota product. I also had a letter from AECOM that recommended the Kubota product. And then I had an email from them that said that they had decided not to go with it, they would not make a recommendation contrary to staff. Have you seen any of those?
No, I've seen the Woodard and Curran letter, which actually disturbed us that it came in March instead of in the early stages, but I have not seen the
May 11th,
that was disturbing to us that it came after a lot of discussions, but we have not seen anything from AECOM on that. They did not want to make a recommendation in the discussions that we had with them.
I got a letter that was emailed to all of us from AECOM that suggested the Kubota membranes was the best option. And then also have an email that they sent that suggested that they had decided they would not go against a staff recommendation.
Okay.
It was sent to all of us, so that's all. I just wanted to see if you had seen it or not.
Didn't notice this.
Okay.
Is there any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion, which is to accept the staff recommendation for the membranes. And that passes 4-1. All right, we're on to item number 2.